Yeah, children. So, polynomials we are discussing. In polynomials, what was the first topic we discussed? Splitting of the middle term and verifying the roots of some of the roots and product of the roots. Then, when roots are given, when some of the roots and product of the roots, how to frame the equation into it. Then we also divided long division method, basic level sums we discussed yesterday. Now, in this long division only, even in this long division only, next variety means two roots they will give or one root they will give. Remaining roots we should find out. This is fourth variety. One, two, three, fourth variety in polynomials. They will give some roots, other roots we should find out. How to find out? Open the link in the description, children. You will find out the sums. So first sum I'm telling all of you, please concentrate. Very, very important sum. Regularly they are asking this question, especially second and third questions are damn important. So many times they ask this question. Chalo, children, I will explain first sum. What is the first sum? They have given 2x to the power of 4. Minus 3x cube minus 3x square plus 6x minus 2. Highest power 4 means 4 roots will be there, or 4 factors will be there, or 4 zeros will be there, or 4 answers will be there. Anything is same, children. Root, factor, zeros, anything is same. Because highest factor 4, 2 they will give, 2 we should find out. 2 they will give, 2 we should find out. What are the 2 factors they gave? X is equal to root 2 is one factor. X is equal to minus root 2 is one factor they give. Remaining two roots we should find out. I hope everyone are able to understand what I'm saying. Two children, four roots must come. Two roots they gave. Remaining two roots we should find out. In 9th class, do you remember, children? Like this question only I told in one method. By trial and error method, find two roots I said in 9th class. By trial and error method, because 4 means by trial and error method, two roots you find out, multiply them, then divide, then you'll get quotient. Split the quotient, you'll get remaining two roots, I used to say. In 9th class. In 10th class, they only gave two roots. We should find out other roots. So 9th was tough because we should find out. Here they only give. I hope you are able to understand. So two roots they have given, children. Two roots they have given. Remaining two roots, we should find out. What are the two roots they have given, children? One is x is equal to root 2, and the one is x is equal to minus root 2. If this comes, x minus root 2, and if this comes here, x plus root 2. Okay, children, this is in the form of a minus b and a plus b. This is nothing but a square minus b square, x square minus root 2 whole square. This for x square minus 2. With this, you divide this, you will get quotient, and that quotient, if you split, you will get remaining two factors. That's all. Whatever the two factors they give, multiply them. You will get one polynomial. With this polynomial, you divide this polynomial. That's all, children. Okay, so. Okay, this also you should do and show. Directly I will get x square minus 2 and I will divide means no. You know what? First you should show in the exam this one how you got x square minus 2, how you got, you should show in the exam. Then you should divide x with x square minus 2, you should divide. Okay, if you divide, same method, children, remaining everything is same method, x square minus 2, long division method, only one sum I'm showing. 2x4 by x square is how much, children? 2x square. 2x square into x square, 2x4. 2x square into minus 2. Minus 4x square. Please check, children. This is minus, this is plus. Compulsory is 0. You should get, children, remember, because this is a factor you only get. Next, minus 3x cube by x square is how much, children? Minus 3x. Minus 3x into x square, minus 3x cube. Minus 3x into minus 2, plus 6x square. No, no. Bring 6x down, children. Minus 3x minus 2, plus 6x. Check, children. This is plus, this is minus, gone. X square minus 2. X square by x square is how much, children? 1. 1 into x square, x square. 1 into minus 2, minus 2. This minus is plus. Compulsory 0 you should get. If you're not getting 0, you did wrong. Now what you got, children? You got 2x square minus 3x plus 1. Split the middle term. 2x square minus 2x minus 1 plus 1. Because minus 2x minus 1x is minus 3x. Minus 2x minus 1x is plus 2. 2x if you take common, x minus 2. Minus 1 if you take common. Okay, children.
Sir, x minus 1.
1 second. Here 1 should come. Here 1, 2, 1, 2, 1. So x minus 1. X minus 1, x minus 1, if you take common, 2x minus 1. Okay, children. So x minus 1 is equal to 0. 2x minus 1 is equal to 0. So, children, this is x is equal to 1. This is x is equal to 1 by 2. Okay. Root 2 and minus root 2, they give. And 1 and 1 by 2, I form. So 1, 2, 3, 4, total 4 roots. Because I just for 4, no? Compulsory, you should get 4 roots like this. You should be able to understand what I said. two roots they will give, children. Remaining two roots, we should find out. How multiply the two roots, divide, quotient, split, you will get remaining two roots. If suppose 3 is the highest factor, they will give only one root, children. With one root only, you divide, you will get quotient. Always you divide, split the quotient, you will get the answer. One sum I told you, children, remaining also so, so same. Anyway, second, third also I will tell, children, becomes very, 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 very important. Okay, children, I hope everyone copied. If you didn't copy, please open the video. You have to pause the video and keep seeing, children. X is equal to root 5 by 3 is one equation. X is equal to minus root 5 by 3 is the other equation. Same procedure. Bring this here. Bring this here. X minus root 5 by 3. X plus root 5 by 3. Please check, children. If you don't, again, problem. A minus B into A plus B. A square minus B square. X square minus root 5 by 3 whole square. Square root gone. X square minus 5 by 3 is equal to what, children? 0. 3 you take LCM. 3x square minus 5 is equal to 0. 3 goes there. 3x square minus 5 is equal to 0. With this you should divide now. With this you should divide. Hope you understood all these steps. These steps you should write. With this you should divide, children. With this if you divide, you will get a quotient. Split the quotient, you will get remaining two roots. Remaining two roots are one root of, children, because highest root is how much? 4. Yeah, remaining two roots you will get. Okay. Shall I show division or no need, children? Shall I show division or no need? Children.
Your wish, sir.
Okay, third one I will show division, children. Okay, with this, don't do with this, children. I'm saying don't do with this. If you do with this, you'll get confusion. Do with this because remove the denominator. With this, you divide that polynomial, you'll get quotients. With the quotient, you'll get remaining two factors. Okay, go to third sum. Because this you have to show, children, in exam. Without showing this, if you're doing the sum, we will not accept and will not give marks. Okay, go to third sum, children. Go to third sum. Go to third sum, children. Third sum is very, very important in textbook 2.4 optional exercise, children. Fourth sum, this is x is equal to 2 plus or minus root 3 are the two factors, he said. Means x is equal to 2 plus root 3 is one factor. X is equal to 2 minus root 3 is another factor. They give two factors. Okay? Please see here, children. This you bring here, this you bring here. X minus 2 minus root 3 and x minus 2 plus root 3. What is this, children? A minus B. What is this, children? A plus B. This is nothing but A square minus B square. I hope you are able to understand, children. This is very, very important. Some optional exercise sum. Okay. So x minus 2 whole square minus root 3 whole square. Square root cancel. A square plus B square minus 2AB minus 3. So what you are getting? X square minus 4x plus 1. With this, you should divide. But this division, if you don't show, you will not get, children, marks. Compulsory, you should show this division. This part, how you got, you should show. Okay, children, now I'm dividing. One sum I'm dividing, show. You please check, children, I'm showing. Okay, what is the question, children? The question is x4 minus 6x3, x to the power of 4 minus 6x cube. Okay, minus 26x squared. 26x squared plus 138x. Plus 138x minus 35. Down it is there. Please check. Divide this with x square minus 4x plus 1. Okay, children. Now, x4 by x square is x square, children. X square into x square, x4. X square into minus 4x minus 4x cube. X square into 1 plus x square. Don't do any mistake, children. Minus 2x cube minus 27x square. Okay, children. And bring 138x down. If it is used, we will use it. This into this, please check, children. Okay, so yeah. So how much you will get? Minus 2x cubed by x squared? Minus 2x cubed. Okay, children. So minus 2x into x squared is minus 2x cubed. Okay, minus into minus plus 8x squared. Minus into plus minus 2x. Check, children. Plus minus plus. Gone minus 35x square plus 140x minus 35. This with the second, children. What do you get? Minus 35. Why do you get minus 35? Okay, children. So when you're doing like that, what do you get, children? Minus 35x square minus 35x square. Okay, minus 35 minus 4x plus 140x. Minus 35, this is minus 35. Plus minus plus gone, gone, gone. 0. Okay, children. Now what you got, children, please see here. x square minus 2x minus that. Let's put the middle term. X square minus 7x plus 5x minus that. X if we count x minus 7. X minus 7. X minus 7 into x plus 5. So x is equal to 7 or x is equal to minus 5 are other two factors. Two factors, what they give children? First, initially what they give? One is 2 plus root 3, other is 2 minus root 3. These two are two factors. Third factor, fourth factor. Because highest power is 4, four factors must be there. That's all. Highest power 3 means 3 factors. Highest power 2 means 2 factors. Okay, children? So remaining all sums also same procedure, children. Fourth sum also, I'm just saying, children, the same fourth sum. I hope everyone copied. This is optional exercise sum, children. Please copy it fast. If you didn't copy, at least take the snap. If you didn't take the snap, check the video, scroll again and again, try to pause the video, keep reading this description. Very, very important. Okay, children. Now next, what is the fourth question, children? Two factors are, one is x is equal to minus 2, and the one is x is equal to minus 1. Alright? If this comes here, if this comes here, x plus 2 into x plus 1. Multiply, children. Listen to this, x squared. Listen to this, x. Listen to this, 2x. Listen to this is 2. X squared plus 3x plus 2. With this, you have to divide the equation. When you divide the equation, you'll get quotient. Split the quotient, you'll get remaining two factors. Same procedure, children. For everything, the same procedure. In fifth sum, children, they gave only minus 2, children. If you bring here x plus 2, with x plus 2 directly divide, children. Because it is three factors on the unit. Yes, children? Right on. Yes, children? Any other sum you want, children? Two pages are there. Any other sum? Please check. Sir, particular sum you want, means I will explain that sum. Check, two pages are there, children. Anyone? Any other sum you want me to explain in detail? Any other sum you want me to explain in detail? Please ask. Any sum, two pages are there, total 17 sums are there. Same procedure, all are same procedures, children. If I give one variety, same variety sum 17. Yes, children, anyone want any sum? You can ask me. Yes, children, anyone? Yes, no want?
No, sir.
Okay, children. So the remaining all sums also remain.